How long does nicotine and other toxins stay in your system? Hi, Nasya Davos here. In this video, I'll answer one of your questions, which is how long nicotine stays in your system and how long other chemicals in tobacco like cadmium and arsenic stay in your system. Maybe you already quit smoking and you want to know how long it takes for all those substances to leave your body. Or maybe you're thinking about and preparing to quit and you want to know when and how long it will take for your body to start feeling healthier, which is of course a great motivation. Or maybe you have to be tested for tobacco use because of upcoming surgery or a job or insurance and you want to make sure you don't have nicotine in your system. So stay tuned to find out how long nicotine and other chemicals stay in your body. Before we get started, subscribe to this channel and hit the bell button so you can get notified when we release more videos that will help you on your quit smoking journey. So first, let's talk about how long nicotine stays in your system, then we're going to talk about other chemicals. So nicotine as a substance, it has a half-life of about 2 hours. Half-life is the amount of time it takes for 50% of a substance to be eliminated from the body. So nicotine's half-life is very short and 50% of it leaves your body in 2 hours only. And in about 3 to 5 days after your last cigarette, almost all nicotine is out of your system. However, if you're gonna be tested to find evidence for tobacco use, these tests don't look for nicotine because it leaves your body so quickly. Instead, they look for cotinine. Nicotine breaks down to metabolites and one of them is cotinine. And it can take 2 to 3 weeks for cotinine levels to drop to those of a non-smoker. I have more resources for you in the description of this video with the different tests for tobacco use and how they work, so check it out. So nicotine leaves your body 3 to 5 days after you stop smoking. That's when the physical addiction is gone. And cotinine leaves your body in about 3 weeks. However, cigarettes, cigars, smokeless tobacco, vaping, they have thousands of chemicals and heavy metals inside that stain your body. And the thing that with other chemicals is that there is not information that's readily available. You can only take special tests to test for those chemicals in your body. And of course, this is hard because tobacco has inside 4,000 chemicals. That's a lot. I'm going to talk to you about some of those chemicals and how long they stay in your body after you stop exposing yourself to them. And all the information I will be sharing is according to the American Agency for Toxic Substances. And like they say, the effects of exposure to any toxic substance depends on the dose, the duration, how you're exposed, your lifestyle, and whether other chemicals are present. So let's get to it. Tobacco has inside arsenic. Arsenic is used in rat poison and was ranked as the most harmful substance in 2001. Arsenic is classified as a group A carcinogen and it leaves residues in your body for several months, even longer. Now benzene. Benzene is a rubber cement, gasoline, and manufacturers use it to make dyes. Also, benzene is linked to leukemia and most of the metabolites of benzene leave the body through the urine within 48 hours after exposure. Tobacco also has hexavalent chromium. You can find this chemical in textile dyes, wood preservation and anti-corrosion products, and colors in paints, inks, and plastics. It is toxic, carcinogenic, and when inhaled, it can cause lung cancer and cancer of the nose. Now, most of the chromium leaves the body in the urine within a week, although some of its byproducts can remain in cells for several years. Tobacco also has acetone. Acetone is the main ingredient of nail polish remover. Acetone will leave your body within 3 days after your exposure stops, after you stop smoking. Tobacco also has cadmium. Cadmium is a heavy metal that the tobacco plant absorbs from the surrounding soils, and that's why this chemical, as well as many others, can also be found in cigarettes without added chemicals because they come from the tobacco plant itself. Cadmium can also be found in battery acid and paint. It can contribute to cancer, cardiovascular disease, and osteoporosis. Now, most of the cadmium that enters your body, it goes to your kidney and your liver and can remain there, unfortunately, for many years. Tobacco also has carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is a chemical released in car exhaust fumes and it is a poisonous gas. When you breathe carbon monoxide, it quickly enters all parts of your body, including your blood, your brain, your heart, and your muscles. And it takes about a full day to leave the body, so it's not that much. And tobacco also has naphthalene. Naphthalene is an ingredient found in mothballs. It is used to create black smoke in simulated explosions, and it is linked to cancer. Now, most naphthalene that enters your body leaves it quickly within 1 to 3 days. And these are just a few out of the 4,000 chemicals that are in your cigarettes. If you want to see a more extensive list of what's in your cigarettes, check the links below. Now, as you saw, some chemicals leave your body in a few days, really quickly, while other chemicals take months, even years to leave the body. So, what can you do about it? Well, the most important thing is to stop using tobacco and let your body expel all those toxins, because every puff replenishes these toxins in your system, so let your body heal. And of course, detox helps a lot. We received a lot of requests from you, so we worked with expert nutritionists and we created a nutrition plan for detox that's specifically for smokers and ex-smokers. So if you want a more structured plan for detox, check the links in the description. But what I want you to take away is that you need to drink a lot of water. You know that, more water than ever before. Exercise helps a lot, whatever you can do, and foods like oranges and carrots have high levels of antioxidants and they can speed up your metabolism too. And I definitely recommend oranges because they are high in vitamin C, and vitamin C curbs cravings and food cravings and cigarette cravings, so it helps a lot. So to sum up, nicotine takes 3 to 5 days to leave your body, that's when the physical addiction is gone, but tobacco use tests look for cotinine that leaves your body in about 3 weeks. Now, other chemicals in tobacco vary depending on how much you used to smoke, your lifestyle, your nutrition, and of course the chemical itself. Like benzene takes 2 days to leave the body, cadmium takes years. And what you can do about it is stay away from tobacco and detox, detox, detox. So thank you so much for watching. If you're watching this video and you want to heal, but you feel stuck, you don't know how to quit smoking, you think you're too addicted and it's gonna be too hard, then the CBQ method is for you. The CBQ method has helped thousands of people quit smoking. It's the same method I talk about in my TED talk, and it helps you overcome the mental addiction so you can find quitting easy and take control of your mind. And I want to show you how you can apply the CBQ method to your own life and find quitting easy. So if you wanna know how to get started with the CBQ, why it works and why it can work for you, we created a video where I put all the information you need to get started with the CBQ method. It's free and it's the foundational video of the CBQ method. You can find the link in the description. Make sure you get it, you're gonna love it. You're also going to get a free PDF starter guide for the CBQ method. This guide is great. It shows you what happens on every stage of the CBQ method and it has great tips. So get the video and let me know in the comments, what advice for detox do you have? If you like this video, hit the like button, share it with someone who can benefit from it, and subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this. See you in the next video.